front row seats for the footy grand final. Your mates by your side. The cheer of the crowd as your team runs out. In your hand, beautiful, delicious, chunky or mincy meat pie.
It was all a dream. It wasn't true. Wake up! It was a dream, my friend.
Was it?
It was. Oh. But you know what? I'm going to make all your dreams come true because Jane DeGraff's here from Nine Honey and she's got all the best footy food in the world. Don't you, Jane?
Good morning.
What have you got, Jane?
Are you okay? Are you all right, Karl?
I'm not sure he is. I'm not sure. You actually are sweating.
I know. There's a lot happening in that dream.
So, Jane, talk us through some good footy foods. And, of course, we've got the QR codes there on the screen to get all the recipes.
Okay, so the first thing you need if you're doing footy finals food is you obviously need a meat pie. Now, the first thing I would say about that is if you want to buy them and heat them up in the oven, that's fine. But if you're making them yourself, it's really important that you find a recipe where it's going to hold together well in your hand. You don't want to bite into it and have it go everywhere. You need something that's going to hold together well. And then, of course, you need your sauces. Now, whether that's tomato sauce or barbecue is up to you, but it's not a meat pie unless it's got sauce on it, yeah?
I put mustard and sauce on my meat pies.
Really? Yeah. You could be tomato, yeah?
Tomato and mustard, yeah.
How do you get the bottom like that? Like what you just said.
Nice and crispy. Okay, yeah. So if you're making them at home, use short crust pastry on the bottom if you're doing them in the pie maker or a little pie tin, and then put puff pastry on the top. The short crust pastry tends to go harder and hold all that beautiful, you know, beautiful gravy in there, which is what you want, so that you can pick them up in one hand and have a bite, which is, you know, the test of a good pie. Can you eat it one-handed?
Yeah, well, we're just going to go to Brookie now, who joins us from the other side of the couch. Brookie, good morning to you. How are you going with the one-handed hot dog? That's two thumbs up, Jane. Tell us about hot dogs.
The greatest thing about hot dogs is you can actually pre-prepare these. So you get your buns, you warm your sausages, you line them up in a tray and put them in the oven. And when you want them, you just bring out the tray, pop it down and set it out with a whole bunch of toppings for people to finish
That's
their own off.
Idea.
So they take one, they put their toppings on. You might want some chili mints and make a chili dog. You might want some cheese. You might want some sauerkraut or some herbs. Yeah. I'm a big fan of doing this because it makes it a little bit more interactive. It also means that the onus is off you if you're serving. You can just go, here you go, guys, everything up to you, and let people help themselves. It's so much fun. I've got a whole tray of different ones here. What are you guys putting on yours? I sent in the jalapeno.
Butchering
and...
your
No, I'm putting onion
dog.
On there because I don't care how my breath is.
I do. I really do. Hey, isn't that the point, like, with footy food? You want it to be really easy. Have you got any good, like, bite-sized snacks? And I think you've got, like, some cool skewers and things.
Sausage
as well.
Rolls.
Okay, so if you want to get everything ready ahead of time, I always suggest putting out a tray of finger food, little mini quiches, mini pies. Again, you can buy them or make them. If you're making quiches, they're a great one because you can do a bunch of different fillings, put them out, and that's like a meal in your hand. Don't have to worry about anything else. I'm a huge fan of that. But you need your classic chips. This is a great one. But don't just do chips. You do chips loaded fries style. And this is so much fun because people can take a basket of their own chips and then they can put some guac on top. They can put some sour cream. I've put a whole lot of wasabi mayonnaise because that's what I like. And then some Parmesan on top of that. It's lots of fun. You can even put gravy on. Turn the chips into a little bit more of a meal if you want to. You're supposed to do it like this, guys. It's supposed to look pretty like that.
Ours doesn't look pretty, but it tastes so good. And really, at the end of the day, that is all that's important, isn't it? How good is sour cream? You can have it on everything, I reckon.
And if you've got the barbecue fired up, don't forget stick food is the best thing too because, again, it's one-handed. You can get it all ready and pop it out on a tray. I've got some chicken skewers and some satay sauce to go on there and I've got some halloumi sticks as well, which is always a good option. Stick food's great because you can just walk around with it, you can grab it, you can eat it, chew with one hand and eat with the other, which is all the fun, right, doing both things.
Yeah, and Brooke's now moved on to... what are you eating now, Brooke? It's far out.
I thought you said they were gherkins. They're jalapenos.
Have you got everything on there, Brooke?
Oh, did you not know that they were jalapenos?
You said they were gherkins.
Yeah, I know. That's what's so funny. See, you thought you were sweating before. Now you're sweating. Hey, thank you so much, Jane. They are great. And for all those recipes and tips, scan the QR code or head to ninehoney.com.au. Well, stay with us. Plenty more to come if Karl can handle the heat. News at 9. That's next. Woo!